first and I found her. Yeah, it's gorgeous.
Say hello to the vloggy vlog.
Hey everyone.
Oh my gosh, we're gonna be testing your food preparations today. I'm so excited.
Alright guys, so we made it to the Airbnb location where we're gonna be filming the seafood boil mukbang. So we're gonna be doing a seafood boil mukbang and very excited. The name of the chef is Chef Jordan. I'm gonna introduce him in a second. Just wanted to show you guys a little bit of the view. So this is like a little discreet location behind the actual complex. But here's where we'll be before one. Let's get right in. So upon entering, you fall right into the kitchen. It's gorgeous. So the fixtures are really nice and modern. And over here you have the living area, gorgeous, and you have this open concept leading into the most beautiful view I've ever seen. Honestly, Montego Bay is known for its views, but I'm honestly just in awe. Like, how gorgeous is this?
Can't wait to taste test and, like, you know, just get to experience his authentic cuisine. Very excited to try this seafood boil. Get my hands dirty, get right into it. So that's the intro for now. I'm so excited and I'm grateful to be here. So yeah, excited to eat. And yeah, I'll check in with you guys in just a second when we're all set up.
For real, look at this view. Like look at this view. Like, be real. Like, be real.
So gorgeous, guys. So gorgeous.
So yeah. All right, guys. So Chef is back. Introduce yourself, Chef Jordan.
Hey, my name is Chef Jordan. I'm from Montego Bay, St. James. Yeah, born and raised.
That's
private
right.
Chef. You know, luxury food. I'm your guy.
Right. So if you're ever interested in booking Chef Jordan, you're on Instagram. What's your Instagram handle?
@chef_jordans. That's it.
Perfect. Okay, so right now he's in the prep phases, mostly finished. We're just going to wait on the presentation,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I'm going to nice it up for you.
Awesome. Very excited. Let me give you your space to get everything done. But guys, as I was mentioning before, this is Chef Jordan. He's all over Instagram, all his work, private chef bookings. I'll link his information in the description below and I'll tag it on the screen so you guys can have access. Right now, just go on your phones. Go subscribe, go, you know, follow his journey. And of course, book him for any private events, functions, things of that nature. You might need a professional and private chef. He's the one. So right now I'm gonna just set up the camera and then you're gonna get my full and exclusive, you know, reaction to this food. The number one private chef in Montego Bay requested that I try out his seafood boil. If you're not following Chef Jordan's, do that right now. His information is linked down below. So this is him prepping for the seafood boil experience. And can you believe in my 28 years of life, I've never tried a seafood boil? Whoa. This is an up close of the garnish. And this is just me super excited, waiting to try this out. So now he's plating and trust me when I say, I was impressed with the layout of everything and I haven't even gotten to the taste test yet. Adding the shrimp on top of the crab and then to top it off, the corn on the side. I had no complaints. If you happen to need a private chef for birthdays, dinners, anniversaries, special occasions, definitely book Chef Jordan's. His presentation and expertise, top tier. This is the final step, you know, a little razzle dazzle, chef's touch. Stay tuned for part two where I do a taste test.
I should have this in my left hand, but I'm not a lefty, so I'm just gonna go with my right. And first of all, guys, as I said, I have never tried a seafood boil. I've had shrimp by itself, lobster by itself, claw, whatever, but never all together, right? And that's the concept of a seafood boil. So Where should I start? I don't even know.
No!
Just dive in, okay.
And the seafood boil is a very hands-on seafood boil because majority of the things are in shells. This is going to be very hands-on.
Next level.
Yeah?
Next level. Amazing. Oh my god, guys. Just as you dive in, you just taste everything. All the flavors, all the seasoning.
Yeah.
Wow. Made with love.
Definitely.
Made with love. You can tell, have you been preparing meals like this for private functions, dinners, gatherings? How long?
Well, I've been doing private functions for about 2.5 years.
Okay.
I started at the beginning of COVID after I resigned from my job to basically go private and full-time with Chef Jordan's.
Okay.
We do weddings, we do receptions, we do dessert stands. We're famous for our donuts.
Donuts too, guys. So not just regular, you know, food stuff. We're talking dessert too.
That's for our part two video.
Okay.
Go to desserts on a part two video.
Okay. Yeah. I'm with it.
Yeah.
Because I got a sweet tooth too.
Yeah?
So.
I got you. Don't worry. Yeah, man. So we do dessert stands.
Nice.
We do private meetings. Stuff like that, cocktail parties as
oh,
well.
Oh wow, okay.
So for example, even if you need a private chef for a villa.
Okay, so villas, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
Things like that, birthdays and stuff.
Right,
okay.
Right, you know?
That's amazing.
We try to cater for intimate events so we can basically control quality as best as possible.
So tell me more about like what inspired cooking for you? Like, how did you know that chefing was your thing?
Well, you know, funny enough, I asked my dad the same question that I need, like, Pops, when did you realize that this is what I really wanted to do?
Mm-hmm.
He said basically high school because at the time when I was at Herbert Morrison, no boys were allowed to do food and nutrition.
Okay.
And I was
interesting.
Really, yeah, that wasn't really sitting well with me at the time.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I wanted to do food and nutrition because that's what I was interested in, and I fought for it and I got it.
Yes.
And then basically after that, a passion developed. My late grandma, Daisy, really, pick up herself, grandma.
Yes, Daisy.
she basically instilled this passion into me. She introduced me to the kitchen from a tender age. And,
okay.
Basic fundamentals.
Well, I'm glad that you did because now you're able to showcase your talents to the world, and like this is just amazing. I can't get past this, guys. It's delicious. Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
And what would you say is like your favorite event to cater to? Out of all the ones that you've done, which one was like super engaging and fun? And
I think for me, last night I did a catering at some friends of mine's party, Montezuma.
Okay, that's nice.
Yeah. Shout out the Coastside Events crew, you know.
So
yeah, we did that catering. It was fun and interactive because it was a live pasta station.
Okay, cool.
And basically got to interact with customers who haven't seen for a very long time because I have been off the scene for some time.
Right.
So you know, they were able to interact with me and get to sample what I had to offer and what they've been missing for a very long time.
Surely.
So I think I'm going to try and do more events. Maybe Dream Weekend can link.
Hello?
Anything possible.
Anything is possible.
You know,
I would agree.
So
and with talent like this, it needs to go like all across Jamaica. Like you need to be at the food festival and those things like that. You
that's
need
the
to
goal,
be there.
That's the goal.
Yeah.
So I'm back on focusing on me right now.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I believe that I'm my biggest asset and I need to really focus on
building that up.
Yeah, definitely.
Tell people where they can find you.
Alright, so everybody can find me on Instagram at chef_Jordan.
It'll be on the screen.
Yeah, so that's chef_Jordan with that S at the end. On TikTok, Chef Jordan's the same. Chef Jordan's 876. Yeah?
Definitely. So follow him. Guys, you guys are just gonna see me eat for the rest of this vlog, I swear. Like this is just absolutely 10 out of 10 would recommend. Not 9, not 8, a whole 10 across the board. We're giving 10s. Delicious, okay?
Yeah, I wish I could eat some right now. It looks amazing. Let me get you some water in the meantime.
Thank you. Yeah, guys, so again, follow him, his work, exquisite presentation, delivery, 10 out of 10. I'm enjoying this. It's just amazing.
TikTok is probably the fastest growing platform in the 21st century. And I think if you don't have TikTok,
Jamaican TikTokers are gonna skyrocket. They're probably soon ban it in the States.
I heard that and I was like, I don't know how I feel about that, to be honest, because like people make their livelihood off TikTok.
That's true. So how often do you do things like this?
Like record videos and stuff like that on TikTok?
Well, I mean, in terms of sponsorship type partnership.
Okay. Honestly, when I have the time. Because I do have like my full-time work in the week. But content creation became a passion last year. Like I was like, I'm going to do this. If I find the time, I'm going to make it happen. So really and truly as often as I can.
All right, guys, so we're all done today. Such a pleasant experience. Thank you so much, Chef Jordan.
My pleasure.
Guys, amazing experience. I'm going to rave and talk about this for a very, 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 very long time.
Rosa's Retreat.
We're in Rosa's Retreat right now. Book them on Airbnb. And of course, book Chef Jordan's for all your private dinner dining experiences. All right, bye. We're out.